potatoes. You probably don't know who it is anymore, but it's Corey. So I'm gonna get on here and I'm going to do the most dramatic journey ever to take part in the Hocus Pocus collection, like an impressions of it. I know what this looks like right now. I'm just accepting it. I'm gonna do an impressions and then I'm gonna do like a look with it. Not at this moment, okay? That's just like how it is. But if I had to get like a blanket statement of why I'm not on here, and I guess apologizing because I know I do have like people that are consistent followers and like check in. Honestly, changing to different school hours, not that it's hard on me, it just takes a completely different schedule than I ever had before, and also cutting time out for myself, which this is good for me, but the work that goes into posting this, I hate, and I feel like I've voiced that like very clear. So the time that I built in for myself with my very limited schedule to be able to get enough sleep for the school hours, this just doesn't have like a good fit in my schedule yet. I want to do better at putting it in there, but at this time moment, I haven't prioritized that, and that's fine because you have to prioritize and set boundaries for yourself. I'm gonna try to work on it. That's it. I always say I'm gonna try to work on it. One day I'll actually work on it. Let's get into this video. The Hocus Pocus collection. I feel like this needs, like, this is story time, impressions, look, because, in comparison, I was online, first off, first day, let's just summarize that day, when they were supposed to launch, October 1st at 12 o'clock our time, it completely failed. Like, site crashed, couldn't know what to do with itself, was asking for passwords, it was a joke. So, ColourPop decided that it was a good choice for them to just pause the launch. We're gonna take a step back. We're gonna try again tomorrow, which I was reading a lot of comments. Everyone really agreed like that was the best thing to do to like make it equitable and like without air the next round for the next day. But I also think that's wild to think that if it was like a huge crash site, I'm just not in the IT world of it, but that you could just rebuild your site with less than 24 hours and like try again and think it would be a success. So whatever. They did that. Next day, same time. Here you go. We're going to do it again. Thanks for being patient. I am on and I'm refreshing the site. I know that's what bogs it down. Everyone's just sitting there refreshing it. I'm refreshing the site and 11:59 a.m. Mine loads. So like literally within that minute, before it even struck 12, I had the lipsticks, the shadow glitter, and the palette in my cart. And I was already signed in. Clicked checkout. Do that. Instantly puts me online. So I pull up Twitter and it says, if you're in line, just stay there. Like you have your spot. It's just because some people are checking out. It'll be your turn soon. I'm like, okay, in my mind, I'm thinking maybe I have it. And then I think six times of it refreshing and putting me back at the checkout and having me check, are you a robot? That I kind of felt like a robot at the end of it because that was ridiculous. At the end of it, six times I got put back in line, virtual online, and 25 minutes later, I finally was, my cart like went through and it told me everything sold out. And so like on Twitter, I don't know the time frame of when they sold out, but like they sold out within, I'm pretty sure, the first 5 minutes, and just everyone was sitting in the cart. So then there's like complete uproar, as you can imagine, online about like, it's in my cart, it should be mine. And then everyone's saying that's not how it works. But if you're in a store, no one, I mean they could, but it'd probably be an assault, but no one can like reach into your cart and grab what you have, even if it's the last item. So people were not justifying, like I was first, even though I literally have no idea where I was in the queue. I'm being honest, if my site loaded a minute earlier, I'm sure so did everybody else's. It sucked. I was very irritated. I was like, whatever. Like I tried twice, it didn't work out. My third try is Ulta. It released on Ulta that following Sunday. I don't know why. I was just like, I want the instant gratification. I want it now. So I didn't even try with Ulta online, probably because the ColourPop experience was like so poor that I just like didn't want to mess with it. So Sunday Ulta, COVID hours don't always reflect where you're supposed to be at when you're supposed to be at. So I was at Ulta 2 hours early, not realizing it because the hours had changed. And so I just sat there. Like, it's like, it's not, the store I went to wasn't worth me to drive back home to turn back around and like go back. So I just sat there, just watched TikToks, not gonna lie. And then I lined up because I saw more cars coming in the parking lot. So I just like got in line 15 minutes prior. I would say a couple minutes passed and this other lady came behind me and she's like in full Halloween gear, like ready to hocus pocus some spells on some people. And I was just like, so we're both online, and so I'm awkwardly like, are you here for Hocus Pocus? And so she tells me her horror story about online. Yes, she was. Keep fast forwarding the story. Third girl lines up. There's only three of us in line. One of them brought her partner. So yeah, I don't know if the partner got anything. So I can see the display. Like my eyes are like, and then I see all the members, all the associates like going around it, obviously like aware, like it was a release today. Like there's a line outside and I see one of their Cookie Monster little hands reach over and grab a palette. And mind you, I can't tell from my depth perception how many palettes there is left. And she takes one, puts it behind the counter. And I know on releases, like they can't hold them for customers, but she's sure to hold it for herself. Fast forward again, door opens, we walk in like civilized people and I should be like the first one up in line, but no, homegirl's hand came, whoop, she said whoop around me, and so I said whoop. And I grabbed like one thing. There was only one unit of it. And I grabbed all my items. I checked out. I was literally in the store for less than the time I stood in line. Like I was in the store for maybe 3 minutes. So that's my story. I got everything I wanted. Long story. Thinking back, I really wish I would have grabbed a second eyeshadow palette because I think this palette is going to be so hard to find. I wish I would have grabbed one more palette for a giveaway. So I sincerely, sorry, I was thinking about all y'all, even though you haven't seen me in June, July, August, September. Y'all haven't seen me in like 4 months. Okay, so I've talked way long enough. So this is the palette. I'll open in a second, but this is the carton unit. A lot of detail in it. Appreciate that. This is the box it was in. I literally love the inside. I was hoping that this gets put on something and it does. So I was very happy with that because I don't like to keep boxes, but I loved that detail. Then I got 3 lipsticks. One for Winnie, Sarah, and Mary. This is a lipstick and a liner. So I got the 3 of those. And then I got this little gel pod. I want to call it more of a topper and you'll see why. But in total, I had a coupon. In total, I spent $80 starting with a muck. I will say, packaging wise, one of the hardest things I have or issues I have with this, you don't freaking know the name of the like product. Like there's 1,000 names on it and I will give examples the whole time. But like, okay, so for starters, I think this one's called a muck. But then the back says glitterly obsessed. The side says I shall always be with you. The other side says so obsessed. The front says glitterly obsessed again. So I have that on there twice. So hard to know what the name of products are because they write things on it so much. And then like you look at the bottom. Oh, that one says a muck. So I don't know. Doesn't matter. But it would just be nice to know if you're like referencing which one. This one has Sir Binks on it. I have played in this to mess around with it. It is a giant container. You probably want to know prices. This was $9. It is a huge container, what I feel like a loose glitter is, but it's very putty like it's just feels like straight jelly. It's really cool feeling, like temperature wise. It is a topper because of how sheer it is, but I do find it buildable in between. But there's big purple pink confetti glitters, and then there is the holographic clear in the background. You definitely cannot use it on its own. You would be Crease Nation, but you could definitely put that as on a topper. That's a second coat. It definitely has some power. As always with glitters, just be prepared for it to be everywhere for forever. That's just how glitters go. I don't really use products like this, but I loved the color of it, so I wanted to give it a try. Okay, the 3 lipstick combo duos. So again, on the front, we have I Put a Spell on You, I Am Beautiful, I Smell Children, all 3 things that they say in the movie. If you watch it, you would know. They didn't then repeat that a second time, and you flip it around, and then we then repeat it a third time, the different name, so making you think that's the name. But then, oh, I didn't even realize on the side they put their individual brooms on there, like Mary has or vacuum. That's adorable. On the side, we throw a second, fourth quote on there. Each person, I suggest we form a calming circle. Boys will love me. Another glorious morning makes me sick. So they throw that on there. Of course, they have their little hair outlines on there. The lip pencil name, they then throw also on the bottom with Splinter Ladies, Lucky Rat Tail, Come We Fly. Again, all things that they said. But prime example, we then change the name and we call it Mary back here. And then we call it Mary under here. So like, I don't know, we were trying to throw a lot of things on a little package and then it just kind of was like misleading. But so this one is Mary, the one that honestly I feel like I look like the most, even though I don't personally vibe with her. Like our personalities aren't the same, but looks wise I would be a Mary. It just is what it is. This is the lipstick tubing. It carries out that cauldron, skull, eye, spiderweb, moon. It's very heavy. I like held this with another lipstick and this is a very heavy compact. I don't know what in the world is on the bottom of these, but heavy Betty for sure. They have little spiders on the lipstick. I feel like Mary was more bright red, like a pink red that they threw on her. And then she gets a lip liner as well. So I'm just gonna put those both on my hand. Much more pink red. And I honestly would just want to be annoying and go back and see like how, because they said that each color was a color match to what they wore in the movie. So I would just want to be annoying and go on there and see that. Next one I'm gonna do is Sarah. same packaging, same heaviness, same spiders. She gets to be more of a berry red. This is currently what I have on, which is a very fall me color, but more berry undertones. And then we get to the queen bee of all time, Miss Winifred. Same packaging, different shade red, and she's much more orange toned. Here she is on the bottom. I feel like the lighting's not showing how much bright that red is. There's a clear difference in color between all three. And from, I would say, the online photos, you really couldn't tell that much of a difference, but when you swatch them, there definitely is. Having Sarah on, it is very transferable, not very forgiving in the sense that, like, one slight move and, like, she's, like, on your face. I put the lip liner on, and usually I, like, my lips to, I don't know, just kind of see where my creases are at, where my lines are falling. And it looked like I had a full face of lipstick on. Like, it covered my whole lip without even putting the lipstick on. So, very, very transferable, not kiss proof. The lipstick duos were $16 each. I don't know why, just the heat of the moment, I didn't realize they were that much. Okay, the last item I got from the collection was the palette. Hocus Pocus Gather Around Sisters is what I'm like 100% sure this is called. Yes, Gather Around Sisters. A lot of detail went into this with the chrome color, the matte color, it's raised. Like every square inch is covered. The binding is like a book. I really wish I knew what these backwards were saying. Like if it had something to do, like that was a spell in the book, just to like add an extra touch. But I will say what I don't like. I don't love our image that we came up with. I don't know who is the graphic designer, but I feel like they made Sarah way more uglier than she was in real life. And Mary, we just said, like, you're a bag of potatoes, like, not paying attention to getting, like, little things grown on it. And then Winnie, they just, like, pinched her face even harder than it was already pinched. And I just don't love how they made them look, because, like, I feel like they were three uniquely beautiful women. And, like, we did not do them justice up here. But I think it must be a Disney look that they came out with, because it's also on my chunky self knows that I instead, the first night I was sad, went and got the Hocus Pocus cookies, and it's the exact same logo. Don't recommend the cookies, but same logo. Nothing crazy, like no color is crazy. Do I think it is a great fall color story? Yes, we're in fall. They tried to release the first day of October. Makes sense. But what I did notice is in so many, like in your basic cream, in your basic brown, little darker taupe brown, in our black, in our deep bronze, instead of it being like a true matte, they threw just like a little bit of glitter in there. And from my understanding, that's like a good way or a cheap way to make a color matte but blendable, which is like less effort, less work. So I don't know if just like the cost of ColourPop, that's just like a common thing for them to do, is like throw just a little tiny bit of like shimmer in the back and it'll make it more blendable, more forgiving, cheaper to make. I don't know, but I did notice that like any color you think is matte, you're like, oop, but I'm gonna get a little gold behind it. And you don't always want a gold outer accent with your black. Just something I've noticed in my use of it. This week I've used On Toast the most, this very just neutral brown. What I will say though, every color I've used has been very true to the color in the pan. Just you obviously, as you can see as I move around, you can see that there's glitters behind a ton of those. It's true to that. It's blendable, but I don't feel like any color is lying to me like when I jump in it. But they name all the things that are like from the movie. So you have Full Moon, Hello Salem, Brew Potion, On Toast, Coven, Come Little Children, Tis Firm, Thackeray Binks, Yabos, I Call It a Bus, Winch, Night of Frolic, Dead Man's Toe, Bewitched, and Goodbye Cruel World, which is kind of cute because I put that as the last one. That's like the last thing she says in the movie. That's cute. Overall, good palette. Horrible, hard to get palette. I'm good with the color story. I know there's a lot of disappointments in it, but I'm good with it. So just my opinion. But something I want to point out, which does come up a lot for ColourPop when I'm following their social media, is people feel like we're constantly changing the graphics, but we're just putting out the same colors. So as soon as they released it, everyone was like, that's Midnight Masquerade, your other Disney collection. Like you're not, all you're doing is putting a new sticker on it and you're giving us the same colors. Like always, I actually have Midnight Masquerade. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't touched it at all, except for like right now to throw some eyeshadow on. I didn't even think about it until I was like, well, I have both, so like, I mean, let's look. Like, what similarities do we see? This is Midnight Masquerade. It has like all the Disney princesses on it. They each have the same amount of shades, and like, yes, looking at them, I do see similarities. So I'm just gonna swatch a couple that like look pretty similar and see like, can we even tell a difference? I'm not gonna do a full story swatch. There's plenty of posts out there like that. I'm just interested for myself because like I said, I haven't used this one at all. And now I have both. So my first one, I'm gonna grab Damsel, which is a mauve pink, which I noticed that it's like the pan is kind of shifted. So that's concerning. First things first, this one's super powdery. Swatches really nicely, but like that's a lot of powder. And then not as pink in pan, I'm gonna grab Hello Salem. Not as powdery and a lot less pink. I feel like this is more rose toned. Like a great transition shade. There's Hello Salem. So not the same first one that I see with my eye. The next one is Pip, which is like their neutral transition shade. And again, that was the one color I used to make this look. Cashmere orangey undertones. And then looking for a clean finger, I'm gonna grab the shade Toast, which is one I've been using literally every day. Much deeper, truer, like cashmere brown without the orangeness behind it. Not the same. The next I'm gonna grab is Mama Odie. I literally don't know what that is referencing, but just looking at it, I literally can tell it isn't the same color, like side by side. There's completely different glitter undertones, but I'm still gonna swatch it. Can you see the green glitter behind that? Kind of reminds me of Anastasia Beverly Hills Jackie Aina palette, that green reflect behind. And then I'm gonna grab Full Moon, but then I'm also gonna do Wint because those are like the two cream shimmers. Full Moon, again, they want it to be cream, but then they throw, can't even catch it in this light, more cream base where the other one is that green reflect behind it, more cream base with little shimmers in it. And then grabbing Winch, a true cream shimmer, beautiful cream shimmer. I need to be rich so I have a good light system. Y'all can't see the difference, I know, because my lighting is what it is. Not the same colors, horrible to see on camera. Like honestly, the last two that I could see people saying like those are the same. New Dream, and compare that to Dead Man's Toe. Very berry, very berry. Again, very chalky. It definitely diffuses out a lot with swatching it. Much more deep purple, much more pigmented. I feel like I'm grabbing the same amount. Two different types of color there. Different. Then the very last one I'm gonna grab is Gaston. I'm gonna compare it to Night of Frolic, which looks more maroon based. This one looks more traditional red. That's really patchy. Yes, they're in the same color wheel. One looks just more like a Friar Tuck red, and then Hocus Pocus looks more like of a maroon. Just swatch so much better. So no, I don't think they're the same palette at all. I don't feel like they're the same pods put in there with a different name. I have said this time and time again, I feel like it can be quoted now in my videos. I don't know what color eyeshadow you come out with that is new at this point. I feel like everything has been done, and at this point where we're at with makeup, it has to do with the graphics, the presentation, the story behind it, the why behind it, and the placement. But I don't think you're ever at this point, we are ever gonna come up with a brand new eyeshadow color that we've never seen before, so things are constantly looking the same. I don't think they're just repeat, new sticker. I think a little bit more thought went into it. But personally, if I had to grab one that I was like I could go to and use way more often, it would end up being the Hocus Pocus over the Midnight Masquerade. Now I'm gonna give a look with Hocus Pocus. Friday Night Corey says, thank you so much for recording this video. I know you're living a brand new life schedule, brand new needs in your life. And regardless, we're proud of you. And whatever look you want with, you're about to slay. That's it, honey. Bye.
Alright, so this is the finished look for one. I already know Carolyn's gonna read me to filth on these lashes because she's gonna say they're way too big, but I committed and I just put them on. So I feel like I also kind of cheated because I did a wing with the palette off camera, but that was just solely because I was just like, this look needs something else once I got done, and so then I put that on. So see through these giant lashes, I used Night of Frolic to create a wing. I don't know if you can really tell because there wasn't, but I used Brew Potion at first to just create like one big cut creased wing. I didn't put mascara on my bottom lashes, amateur. And honestly, this is the first time that I've worn lashes since doing castor oil for like months, so that's also kind of wild. I do miss a good lash look. Past self told myself I was gonna kill this look, and I'm sorry, I killed this look. I'm just gonna say that. Very fall, or you could do very Christmassy with that pop of red. So adorable. Okay, so overall thoughts. One, I need to buy way more baby wipes because this palette is really messy. Night of Frolic, their matte shades, which I had talked about the difference in their matte shades and their kind of shimmer matte shades. Their matte shades are so messy, but it does have true pigment. Like, I feel like I didn't have to work at all hard to get that color. Like, that color was like a tip of a brush put on and it was there. Then I talked about how messy the lipsticks were, and honestly, we're gonna go see Hocus Pocus tonight. That was not planned that I did this day, but we're gonna go see Hocus Pocus tonight at like an outdoor fall thing. And so I honestly just don't want my lips to run like crazy. So I used a different liner. So I used a different one in the shade Rosewood by Bodiography. But then I went on and I mixed two shades. I put Mary right in the center, and then I followed that, finish it through with Sarah. Overall, last impressions, I really like the palette. I like the payout. I think it is very cute collector's item as well. Like, so much detail went into this. I do think it gets a little messy. Oh, I didn't use this guy, but I'm not adding any more to this because this just feels like perfection. But okay, that's everything I have to say. Thank you so much for watching, and there's a giveaway in the description box. Go ahead and click that, and see you next time. Bye, potatoes.